Hello, and thank you for showing an interest in our research. My name is Lasse Giil, and together with Leifoto-Vatne and co-authors, we have just published the paper Cerebrospinal Fluid Quinolinic Acid is Strongly Associated with Delirium and Mortality in Hip Fracture Patients. How a range of medical and surgical conditions can give rise to a similarly altered mental state that is observed in delirium is a big scientific question. Inflammation, the common denominator, is often the suspected culprit. However, it is not clear exactly how inflammation leads to altered cognitive and psychiatric states. Our take on this is that this could be mediated by the kynurenine pathway. Tryptophan is degraded to kynurenine by two rate-limiting enzymes that are both induced in an inflammatory state. And kynurenine can cross the blood-brain barrier and give rise to two neuroactive compounds, quinolinic acid, produced by microglia, and kynurenic acid, produced by astrocytes, that interact with the N-methyl D-aspartate receptor. The N-methyl D-aspartate receptor, or NMDR receptor, is strongly linked to psychiatric illnesses and is the target in a specific form of autoimmune encephalitis that can have a lot of psychiatric symptoms. In order to investigate this, we obtained parallel cerebrospinal fluid and serum samples from three groups of patients. Cognitively unimpaired adults, that was patients undergoing elective surgery, where samples were taken during spinal anesthesia. And the main group, hip fracture patients, where samples were obtained in a similar manner, and patients followed daily during admission for symptoms of delirium. And finally, a positive control group with medical delirium. This consisted of patients that underwent lumbar puncture due to symptoms of infection and an altered mental state, but whom ultimately were shown to have delirium and, for example, pneumonia. The age and gender distributions are listed below. This lists all the measured kynurenines and odds ratios in unadjusted and adjusted analysis, which were also adjusted for multiple comparisons. Briefly, quinolinic acid in both adjusted and unadjusted analysis were mostly associated with delirium. It had the strongest association. Other kynurenines produced by microglia remained significant in adjusted analysis. However, kynurenic acid and serum metabolites were confounded in adjusted analysis. Here, I would like to focus the viewers' attention on quinolinic acid and its concentration in the different cohorts. In cognitively unimpaired adults, the concentration is strikingly similar to that of patients with hip fracture and no delirium. Moving to patients with delirium and medical delirium, the concentration is almost twice as much. We also investigated whether the kynurenines were associated with any negative outcomes. We measured neurofilament light chain, a biomarker of neuronal injury, and among all the serum and CSF kynurenines measured, CSF quinolinic acid had the strongest association with neurofilament light chain, and this remained in adjusted analysis. Furthermore, it also had the strongest prediction of mortality after 1 year, where there were 99 events in 450 hip fracture patients over 1 year. Quinolinic acid remained significant in adjusted analysis. Expanding somewhat on the neurotoxicity question, we also investigated whether there were patients with delirium who had CSF quinolinic acid concentrations that were as high as in studies on animals that have shown neurotoxicity. And those were 100 and 300 micromolars per liter. And indeed, this was present in a significant number of patients with delirium, but very few without. This leads to our proposal based on our paper, and this is that delirium could be due to the effect of acute illness on inflammation, which induces the kynurenine pathway and ultimately leads to elevated quinolinic acid in the brain, which can interact with the NMDR receptor. This could lead to an altered mental state, but also to neurotoxicity, and could be a potential explanation of why some patients just never recover following delirium. However, these are questions for further research, as our study was observational and cannot really determine cause and effect relationship. Thank you very much for paying attention to this presentation and for showing an interest in kynurenines and delirium.